This is now the spiritual home of the Basque people. This is the assembly house of Guernica and also the old oak tree of Guernica. Mm-hmm. For ages, during centuries, even before we had the first documents, written documents, our Basque people spread out in the provinces of Biscay and Guipúzcoa, they used to hold their meetings under a tree, under an oak tree like this one here. And they maintained this kind of tradition. And back in the, during the 19th century, this assembly house was built so as to celebrate here the meetings to discuss political problems and problems that they had in common, different villages all around Biscay, the province of Biscay.
I believe there was a time when you weren't allowed to have your own government.
That's right. That was after the Spanish Civil War. We were about to obtain our Statute of Autonomy at the beginning of the 30s, the 1930s, but then the Spanish Civil War broke out in 1936. And after 3 years of civil war, he was the one who won, General Franco. So during those 40 years, he suppressed not only Basque culture and Basque language, but also the right to have our own parliament, our own institutions to make up decisions and to make up rules or laws.
So the Basque people have their own government and they're autonomous now?
In any of our three little provinces, we have our own parliament, like this one here. But this one here, apart from being the parliament of Biscay, it's also the spiritual home of the whole Basque people because of that history about the tree.
Now that you have autonomy, why are there still people who want to separate?
It has to do with the past. I mean, as we have a different past, a different history and a different culture, our own language and so on, what they want is to obtain a higher level of autonomy that would turn into a different nation.
Would that require another civil war?
No, I don't think so. In my opinion, I mean, though nowadays, these days you can get sometimes in our cities people demonstrating what they feel about this political problem, I don't think that another civil war is about to begin. It's just, time will tell who has the right, or time will tell who wins this battle, but I don't think that a new civil war is likely to happen.
So this is a Catholic cathedral?
Yeah, this is a thick building. This is the cathedral we are trying to restore.
Are you talking about that big crack here?
Yeah. This crack maybe comes from the 16th century. It has too much weight on.
Yeah, the building itself has too much weight on it.
Yeah. It seems to be like an enormous flower, stone flower, opening because the weight on.
So that's a beautiful analogy for something that's not good at all.
It's not good enough because it's a little bit dangerous, but we can manage. We are trying to restore it. It's open, you know.
Now, how old is this cathedral?
They began to build this in 1200, and they finished about the last years of the 14th century. And from that time, all the cathedral was opening. Too much weight.
So you started restoring it, and that's when you found the bones?
Yes. When we started restoring the cathedral, we knew that we should find plenty of bones because people were buried inside the church. And we found them. We found the history of Vitoria, we found the history of this cathedral, because that bones, the meaning are like documents that explains to us the history around this cathedral.
So hopefully we can have the archaeologists show us the bones.
Yeah.
Outside, a team of archaeologists were excavating the bones. They were the bones of ancient Christians buried in or near the church. These are full bodies.
Yes, full. It is all full of bodies.
Oh. And how old are these bodies here?
These bodies were 700 years old. Yes.
700 years old?
700 years old, yes. From the 13th century.
So now, how were they buried? Were they buried in caskets or were they buried in cloth?
know, the, some of them were buried in bags, and another just with clothing.
Now, can you tell the sex of these?
Well, right now, I don't know, probably women, but we can tell the sex, sure, after we make a most deep study in the lab. We have a record system very complete. We have the body, draw it three-dimensionally in the computer, and we make a lot of photographs, digital photograph and slides. We can tell even what he did during his life, not the job of the people.
Wow.
Yeah, the different kind of jobs, of physical jobs.
That sounds very interesting.
Yes, to me, yes.
Oye, y que vienen a buscarte este mundo.